Good morning. Today I want to talk to you about parasites and Bible parasites. How can I call another human being a parasite when we're all human, we all make mistakes, we all have stuff inside ourselves we need to work on to improve and to be better human beings? And important, we apologize to other people for our mistakes. So how can I call another human being a parasite? I want to use an example. Let's imagine I'm an alcoholic, I get aggressive, I drink too much, and I hit my wife in the face and she ends up in hospital. Would it be fair for me to go to hospital the next day and then blame her for everything that happened? She was the one that made me mad. She's the one that makes me drink. And she was the reason I hit her in the face. You see, that to me is the difference between a parasite and a normal human. Because me and you will look in the mirror and we will say, listen, I've got a mistake. I must stop drinking. And I will apologize to that person. The parasite is going to convince you and himself that they're perfect. Okay, but how do you know then that you're in a relationship with one of these parasites? Well, it's easy. How do you feel? Do you feel like you're being controlled? Do you feel like you're always doing everything wrong, like that you're going crazy? Do you feel like you are in prison? And do you feel like you cannot get your breath when you're around these people? That's how you know you're with a parasite. Now, I want to talk about Bible parasites specifically because these are the most dangerous ones to me. Remember, you're dealing with a person that's broken, empty, very sad inside, and it's got a very low self-esteem. But unlike you and me, they're not willing to work on themselves. They want to blame other people for their mistakes. So why the Bible parasite? These empty, broken, sad individuals use God and the Bible and Jesus Christ to convince themselves and you and me that they're beautiful children of God, they're beautiful, perfect human beings. What you do then is you believe that and you think, but wow, this is a beautiful, beautiful person of God because look what they're doing, talking so much about God. And then everything that happens, it goes wrong. You blame yourself and you say, but I'm doing something wrong. And then you feel like you're going crazy. You feel like you cannot do anything right. How do you spot the difference between a Bible parasite and then a real Christian, a real child of God? It's about this again. When they talk about all the beautiful verses in the Bible, how unbelievable God and Jesus Christ is, ignore that for a moment and look at their lives. Look at every minute in their life. You will find the Bible parasite. They smoke, they drink, They swear at people, they use bad language, they steal, they usually break up marriages. The bottom line is they do whatever they want whenever they feel like it, when it's about themselves. But when it's about you and me, they control us using then God. Because now you think, okay, fine, who's going to argue with God? So you think, okay, fine, but this is a great person of God, and you think, okay, the mistake is yours. But you see now, it's all about control. You've been put in prison and you feel like you're going crazy. This is something that's very important to me because these come up perfect individuals has convinced themselves that they're perfect and you're always the problem. So that endless emptiness inside themselves, they'll never be able to face the mirror and say, but listen, I've got mistakes, I need to change. They've convinced themselves they're perfect and now they're going to take that emptiness and they're going to blame you for it and they're going to destroy your life. This is a very dangerous type of person to me because not only have they convinced themselves, also manipulate you into believing they're perfect and they destroy your life. So I wanted to share this with you. You're welcome to leave a comment. I would love to hear from you. Have a nice day.